Hi and welcome to another video for linmob.net. In this video, I'm not going to do what I usually do, just run through some distro. No, I'm going to explain to you how to, you know, get started if you receive that Plasma Mobile KDE Community Edition right now. So you first need to remove some plastic, and then in here is the PinePhone. It's going to be wrapped in plastic, and well, you're going to figure out how to remove that, right? If not, watch one of my unboxing videos that are linked below. And then you need to do something that is very important, and you need to open the phone here at this edge. So from the front, that's the bottom right edge, right? And that's going to be a lot harder than here with my half a year old PinePhone. But you're going to do it. It's going to be fine. And then you won't have an SD card in there. Yeah, sorry for that. And if there is, then something went wrong. But you're going to have to remove the battery. And here's going to be, there's going to be some plastic strip here. And you need to remove that. And then you can maybe put an SD card, which goes in this upper slot, or a micro SIM card that goes in that lower slot. I don't have one handy. But there's a SIM card adapter in that PinePhone box. So if you've got a nano SIM card, that should be workable. Yeah. Honestly, if you still have that plastic that came with your nano SIM, maybe you can use that too, because that might definitely fit a little better, because it's going to have the exact same height as your SIM card. But yeah, so then let's put that stuff back together. And press the power button, right? So let's see how that goes. Now, keep in mind, the software on this, it's running off the eMMC. There's no SD card in there. And it's the factory image that actually is going to be the exact same software that's on your PinePhone then. So even though this is an older edition, the experience is going to be similar. So this is the first boot. Okay, it's rebooting. Here we go. So there we are. And we then need to enter the default pin, which is 123456. And here. And we're there. So what to do now? Well, let's get on the Wi-Fi, right? Because we don't have a SIM card in there, so yeah. Let's open the settings panel here. I may have actually accidentally turned off the Wi-Fi there, but I'm going to switch it on using that button. And then hit then my Wi-Fi network and enter the URL of my blog, which you should check out if you haven't yet, and get connected. Yeah, that connection got just activated, so that's great. And now we should quickly be prompted by the software updater here. See that? Discover, view updates, and we're going to say, hey, show me those updates, right? To see those. And here's some errors, but those shouldn't affect our upgrade here. That's just regarding FlatHub, which is one of the ways to install applications that aren't available for your distribution. But with Manjaro, you should be pretty much fine. Okay, so there's some authenticity check that went wrong there. So I'm going to hit, well, I'm going to accept it for the current session only. And now we need to do this system upgrade. And that's going to take a while because it's almost a gigabyte. So really try doing that on Wi-Fi unless you've got unlimited data. And really important, if you do that, and I'm going to put the phone down here a bit, but I need to use this so that my e-light doesn't called that reflection, and then I'm going to plug it in to power, and you should do that too, because you don't want your battery to die during this upgrade, right? Okay, now let's wait. See you soon. Okay, now something happened to my update. So let me try. Okay, now I can restart the computer to finish the update. Yeah, it's not just a phone, it's a real computer. Let's face it, it's running desktop Linux, so that's an appropriate description, I guess. So it's like I have to turn it off manually. So let me do that. So I'm pressing the power button, leaving it, and then, okay, let's restart. And now it's restarting. Oh, there we are. Great. So here we are again, and not sure whether it did actually update yet. Okay, it connects to my Wi-Fi network again. That's nice. And it says updates available again. That's the same 327 packages it said earlier. It had to upgrade, so let's see if it can do it. Now that it's all downloaded, it should just apply those, right? Okay. Again, it apparently requires a restart. Now I'm prompted to actually initiate that restart, so maybe something went wrong there the first time. So it pays off to be patient, I think. It might work better for you. I hope it does. But I think now it's going to boot and install the updates and then reboot again. So it's booting. Whenever the red light comes up, that means that it's booting. Okay, yeah, now it's installing the updates. That's great. So let's hope that goes well. Oops, sorry for that. Really, plug it in while it does that. You don't want your phone to die because the battery is empty during this. Okay, this looks fairly nice. There's a different wallpaper now. This is the default wallpaper for Plasma 5.21. So no surprise there. And yes, here we are. That's current Plasma now. So this seems like it worked just fine. Which is great, but you really need to stick to using Discover here, maybe reboot once more than you think should be necessary, and then wait a long time, plug it in during that time, because it's doing a lot. You know, it's upgrading 327 packages, which is quite a lot, honestly, and then you can start using this. So I've been doing videos on Plasma Mobile before, and I don't think there's anything new that's pre-installed here. I mean, it's smoother. There have been some cave-in patches and so on, but I think I'm going to tackle that in a later video. I can't test phone calls right now. You're going to figure that out on your own. And yeah, okay, apparently this is how I move apps. Just if you read about some app, you know, like, you know, it might happen that you, for example, just an example that might happen. So your starting angle for this default web browser here, right? And yeah, you're also starting something else. This looks like, right? What did I start there? Oh, yeah, Calendari, the calendar app, which is excellent. So you're starting this now, and somehow you end up typing this address here, and then you're here, and you're like, oh, yeah, that's the block. Let me scroll down, and then let me hit this there, and you might end up on an app list, and you'll think, hey, all these apps that are still loading here, how do I install those? Well, you can do that using Discover too. For example, one interesting app, if you've got a Pinetime or another supported smartwatch, like a Mi Band or an Amazfit watch, and that comes packaged here with Manjaro, is this app Amazfish, so you can install it. I don't think it's on my app list there yet, but it's really simple to install apps like this. So, for example, there's no email client pre-installed, and you could now go into this list and search mail. Hope it works. Yeah, this website unfortunately is terribly slow on the PinePhone. Okay, yeah, I see Geary and Cube and Newsflash, which isn't a mail app. I don't know why it shows up there. Maybe there's the word mail in there somewhere. So you can then see, okay, GNOME 3 desktop, Cube is for Plasma, but now if you want to try those, just go to Discover and check that out. Again, right, you can simply go back here and search Cube. And here it is, it's packaged for Manjaro. Installs, boom. It's there. And if you want to run Geary because you're not sure which one is better, you can install that. Really simple here too. And I hope that's the mobile variant, because otherwise, yeah. Now you've got those two launchers for Cube. I don't know why it has two launchers. Some funny bug. And then you can basically choose your poison. I would always go with other account and then enter the details here. Hit save, and maybe it works. I never actually used it. I'm sorry for that. So yeah, that's how you would go ahead and install apps. And otherwise, the basic navigation is very much like Android. So swiping down, of course, doesn't work right now, right? It's so smooth usually, but then you demo it on camera and it just crumbles. But I installed a lot of, I think it's installing stuff in the background and it's getting warm. Yeah, so maybe I'm pushing it too hard right now. Yeah, but generally, this is much like Android, right? And this here, actually, too, that's the home button. This one is multitasking, and if you want to quit an app, you can simply hit that X there, and the app is being closed immediately. And if this bar isn't there because the keyboard's open, just swipe down on the keyboard, hit the X, and it's gone. So I think that's what you need to know for now. And you can watch my other videos and have fun with your new PinePhone. Goodbye, and have a great week.